guys, welcome back to Wrestling World. Today we'll be taking a look at a new developing story with Lars Sullivan and what got leaked. We'll also take a look at how WWE just announced something involving AJ Lee that even has WWE superstars talking as well. Let's start the wrestling news off with Lars Sullivan. Lars Sullivan is one of WWE's favorite superstars. He's not overly popular with the fans at this current moment, but he's reportedly very popular backstage. They have a lot of big things planned for him. Lars first came to the main roster a while back and was being groomed for a lot of big moments with top WWE superstars. There were plans to put him in the ring with John Cena. There were plans to build him up for a match with Brock Lesnar. That's how much potential WWE saw with Lars Sullivan. I don't know if a majority of fans really feel the same way though. We did another poll over on Instagram and 51% of you guys said that you weren't excited for his return. So the community seems to be pretty much 50-50 when it comes to how they feel about Lars Sullivan. Well, after recovery from his injury, Lars Sullivan just returned to WWE and is picking back up from where he left off at, just running through anyone that's in his way. Lars had a lot of controversy going on outside of the ring over the last few years. He made some outrageous comments on a forum a long time ago and many other things. WWE's only response to the controversy was to fine Lars Sullivan $100,000 for the messages on that forum. However, another outside of the ring situation has just popped up with Lars Sullivan again, and it has some fans talking. Lars was having these constant conversations with a yoga instructor on Instagram, and things started off normal but quickly went over the rail and he crossed the line several times. The instructor has come out responding to the rumors and said that it was true. She shared several messages where Lars was messaging her from his official Instagram account and how badly he crossed the line several times. She was speaking to him for a while trying to be friendly, but when he kept going out of bounds, she had to block him. She said, "I give him the benefit of the doubt and was friendly, but a line was crossed." So obviously a horrible look for Lars Sullivan and also for WWE since he is one of their highly featured talents. It's not even a rumor anymore. She had these official messages and has fully put them out and showed all the evidence she has. So this actually happened. Lars is building up an extremely shaky history online. The important thing here to question is, what will WWE do to Lars Sullivan this time around? Will it be another little slap on the wrist with a fine, or will more disciplinary action be taken against him? If this was a football player or another athlete like that, he'll likely be cut from his team the very next day. But things seem to be different in WWE. We've already seen him go through one big controversy before that made headlines everywhere, and all they did was fine him, so I honestly wouldn't expect them to really do anything this time around either. Reports claim that WWE is now aware of this situation after the article was just released a few days ago, and that he doesn't have much support left in the locker room given everything he said online over the years. But what's most important is that he still has the support of the higher-ups, and as long as you have that, there really isn't anything that's going to stop you. He is one of WWE's absolute favorite superstars. You can't really say the rules don't apply to him, but it definitely feels like that. All his situations continue to be put under the rug. So we'll have to wait and see how WWE plans to respond to this new situation for Lars Sullivan. But until they do, everything for Lars's career still seems to be unaffected. So we got some really interesting things to note here that a lot of fans picked up on. We were just talking about AJ Lee earlier in the week for the comment she made about her new comic. Well, now we have something interesting to note between WWE and AJ Lee. The official WWE Twitter account announced AJ Lee's old match and even tagged her in the post. WWE Twitter had this to say: @RealPageWWE verse @TheAJMendez. You love to see it. They then posted the link to their old match along with a few of the eyes emoji. The tweet really went viral for WWE, picking up thousands of likes within the first hour of it being posted. The reason why this new post from WWE mentioning AJ Lee really blew up was because they haven't mentioned or legitimately tagged her Twitter account in any posts in several years. Usually, if WWE tweets something old about AJ Lee, they would have just put her name, or they would have put a hashtag AJ Lee, so that they don't have to tag her real account. WWE hasn't tagged her new AJ Mendez handle not once. So to see the official WWE account go out of their way to legitimately tag the AJ Mendez was a big eye-opener alone. Obviously, we always say that WWE loves to get people talking, so obviously they knew what they were doing by tagging AJ Lee and putting the eyes emoji in that tweet as well. They knew the conversation they were going to start up, and it definitely worked. WWE fans in the comments section of the tweet were quick to notice how this was the first time in years that they actually tagged her. One fan even joked around and asked, "So, we can finally talk about AJ Lee again?" They said that because AJ Lee's name has sort of been shadow banned over the last few years. Not officially banned, but they weren't trying to mention her if they absolutely didn't have to. So seeing this tweet from WWE actually acknowledged her existence has fans wondering if they can actually talk about her again. The tweet also sparked a response from the other woman who was tagged in the same post, Paige. Paige responded by saying, "Would do this again. Lace up those chucks, sis. Hashtag freaks and geeks." Paige is obviously talking to AJ Lee with that tweet, telling her to lace up those chucks and come back. This sparked a response from CM Punk, who responded by saying, "Oh boy." Paige responded to CM Punk with a very sarcastic and indirect jab at WWE. She had this to say, "It's fine. By the time we go on, our time will be cut. Go in, old school diva roll up, and she'll be on a same night flight home to you." Paige was obviously referring to the fact that WWE women always used to get their matches cut down in time. So much that they would literally only have time in a match to do a quick roll-up finish. So Paige is letting CM Punk know that, hey, don't worry, the match will be 30 seconds long, and she's coming right back home. It's a shame, but Paige is right. That's how things were during her feud with AJ Lee. The matchup looks great on paper, AJ Lee versus Paige. But Paige and AJ didn't have a real legendary match because they never had the right amount of time given to them. You have Paige wrestling since she was a young teenager, AJ training all her life as well. I believe they would have had a classic match if they were given maybe 15 or 20 minutes. But all their matches against each other were 7 minutes, 8 minutes, 9 minutes. It's just not enough time for them to tell a story. Obviously, the women are treated so much better in today's WWE. There's rumor that Sasha Banks vs. Bayley at Hell in a Cell will even main event the show over the men's matches involving the Universal title and the WWE title. So that goes to show you how much has changed. But Paige and AJ know the struggles they had to go through during their run in WWE. Paige was even there for a match that started the hashtag of Give Divas a Chance. The fact that four women had a 25-second long match on a 3-hour program was the breaking point for the fans, and they truly made their voices heard. But what are your thoughts on WWE announcing AJ's matches and tagging her in the post for the first time in years? Is it a big deal or no big deal? How do you feel about the Lars Sullivan situation as well? Leave your comments below. Don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.